artificial intelligence. So we believe now, as the reason we believe that artificial intelligence is ready for prime time, you know, we've heard about it for years and years, and it's been great for science fiction. But until recently, until Amazon and Netflix started making suggestions for what we might like to buy or watch, and Apple launched facial recognition, until those goods and services came about, it didn't really affect our lives. So why do we think artificial intelligence is ready for prime time now? It's ready because we've taken the human programmer out of a large part of the equation. So we do a lot of work on autonomous vehicles, for example. In autonomous vehicles, we know that a programmer cannot possibly imagine every permutation that might happen in terms of intersections and lane changing and so forth. Just not possible. However, you unleash big data and iterative algorithms and supercomputing power and just push those together. This is very hard for a human being to accept, but they will come up with better answers and can imagine many more permutations once we train them. And we just need to train them with data and algorithms and supercomputing power to reach an outcome that a human being does set. I'd like to get from point A to point B safely and as quickly as possible. So as we have analyzed the opportunity for our artificial intelligence, we took a look back at the former computing wave. So the PC wave was the first one. That's responsible right now for about $4 trillion in market cap. Then over the following 20 years to 2018, another $10 billion we can now attribute to the internet. And we believe over the next 20 years that there will be $30 trillion worth of market cap out of there created because of artificial intelligence compared to $1.5 trillion right now. So that's a 14% compound annual growth rate. I believe that is way too conservative because all we're doing is assuming that artificial intelligence has the same amount of impact on the market as the internet did globally. We believe that artificial intelligence is going to impact every line item of the income statement, and any business leader not trying to figure out, you're going to hear a lot about AI here, not trying to figure out how it applies to his or her P&L line is going to be in competitive trouble. So here, of course, are the ways, and again, I won't dwell on these, but Amin did in his videos show how biometric is going to become very, very important in terms of preventing fraud and analyzing credit risk. So we're pretty excited about what artificial intelligence is going to continue to do. To give you a sense of what AI is already doing, you can see on the right-hand side traditional lenders versus Square. Square, in case you're not familiar with it, is, if you've ever seen a mobile phone, you'll see, I don't know if it's in this country yet, I don't think so, but they'll be able to put a little square on top of the mobile phone so that we can swipe our cards. And you've got merchants running businesses on their mobile phone with Square's apps. And because Square is able to monitor every transaction every minute of the day of these businesses, it has so many more data points than a traditional lender. When Square says to a merchant, you know, it looks like you might need a working capital loan, or you might want to invest in some equipment. So it's starting to help small businesses build their businesses because it has all of this data and is able to understand the kinds of risks it's dealing with. But look at the difference between Square and traditional lender. It has 300,000 data points to make decisions on, whereas a traditional lender has 800. It's able to make these decisions in 7 minutes, maybe not 2 seconds, like Amin said for Alipay, but 7 minutes compared to 60 to 90 days for a traditional lender in the world of small business is a world of difference. And you can see the difference between the kinds of data they're dealing with. Continuous real-time data for Square and discontinuous and discrete for the traditional lender. So there's no competition here. There's just no competition.